Coming up in this Brightline Construction Update. This update is my eighth look at the bridge construction progress in Brevard County, Florida. There are a total of six bridges with various dates of completion in southern Brevard County, Florida. We'll look at Horse Creek, the Eau Gallie River, Crane Creek, Turkey Creek, Goat Creek, and the Sebastian River. We'll start at Horse Creek. This is my first time here at Horse Creek, as construction is just about to begin on the bridge for the second track here. The existing bridge here is still relatively new in comparison to the others, so it will continue to be used. Crews will just build a bridge for the second track here. So far, crews have built up the banks so they can work off of them. The crane will be based on the north side of the creek. The crane for this bridge was recently delivered and is on the right of way in the distance as crews begin to assemble it. In the distance, just before the curve, is the post road crossing. The existing bridge here is a concrete one with a ballasted deck, similar to what Brightline will be building. There has been no track work on either side of the creek, likely so crews can access the bridge site. This should be a fairly quick bridge to build, with no demolition work and only one track to build for. Next up is the Eau Gallie River. Here, crews are continuing to install pilings for the future bridge. So far, pilings have started to be installed for three of the future piers. There's a small barge here, which provides crews water level access. Work has also progressed on removing segments of the old bridge so these new pilings can be installed. And here's an engineer's eye view heading across the bridge. South of the Sarno Road crossing, ties and rail have been laid. In the distance near the curve, the track's been shifted to broaden the curve. Crane Creek is next. Here, work is beginning on the west side to construct the new temporary trestle. The crane has been moved to this side, and the pilings are starting to be installed. The Pilings for the rest of the temporary work trestle had been staged alongside the old bridge after they were removed while the trestle on the east side was disassembled. On the east side of the bridge, the final pier for the first track of the new bridge is almost complete. Forms are still installed around it. The abutment on the bank is nearing completion as well. As for the rest of the new bridge, beams are installed all the way to the north bank. The beams for the last three segments have recently been installed, including the one over Melbourne Avenue. Work should begin shortly on their decks. Past the bridge, a retaining wall has been installed, and subroad bed has been laid in preparation for the second track. Several parking spaces were removed to make way for the second track. And here are those three new spans. And here's an overview of the full east side. And here's the west side. The old bridge here will be completely removed when the first track of the new bridge is complete and open for trains. The second track will be built where it is currently located. The end result will be two tracks across Crane Creek. Turkey Creek is up next. I actually saw a crew at work, so this will be a look at the overall progress, plus a look at what they were working on. Crews are currently installing pilings on the west side for the new bridge. The old spans for the former second track here have been completely removed. All of the work here is being done from the temporary work trestle here on the east side. Staging for all of the work is on the north side of the bridge. All of the pilings look to be in place for the southern pier, while crews were actively installing the third piling on the northern pier. and here's a short look at the piling being hammered into place. You can see it drop slightly with each head of the hammer. Here is another look at the staging on the north side. One downfall to working from the temporary trestle on the other side of the track is that every time a train comes, all equipment has to be cleared from across the track. Unlike the other locations where crews just have to stop working when a train passes, here they have to disconnect the hammer rig and swing it to the other side of the track. Here crews are disconnecting some of the pipes that run the hammer mechanism. The crew also had to be moved away from these pilings, so this lift is swinging over to get them. And here's the rig swinging out of the way. This has been sped up for the sake of time. All of this was being done in advance of the arrival of Florida East Coast Railway Train 105, which you can see passing in full at the link above. Goat Creek is up next. Work here is almost finished. The second track of the new bridge looks to be complete, and an initial layer of ballast has been laid across it. Short sections of rail are also staged on it, waiting for ties to be laid. Crews look to be finishing the removal of the temporary work trestle. There are still two pilings that need to be removed. It should not be long until the second track is laid across here. Our final stop is the Sebastian River Bridge. Crews continue to make steady progress on track 1 of the new double track bridge here. Beams are now installed about halfway across the river, and pilings are continuing to be installed heading south. part of the old bridge is being demolished as the new bridge progresses south. Six additional piers are in various states of completion. Here is a flight north along the bridge. Equipment is now being staged on both the north and south banks of the river. Here's a straight down look, flying from the north side to the south side. It also looks like work is beginning to clear some of the brush on the east side of the south bank, likely so another temporary trestle can be built on that side as well. Here is one final overview flight across the whole bridge. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.